Hey YouTube, how's it going? My name's John, and today I'm playing Ghostbusters Doom. And this is an interesting little mod with a slightly interesting history. It started in 1998 as a total conversion. They were planning on changing all the weapons, all the monsters, replacing all the levels, all the music, and you know, the whole nine yards. But unfortunately, it never got finished. They got pretty close, but never got to a final product. The last update for this mod was in 2002, and he just never picked it back up. But what's left over is pretty cool and interesting and worth taking a look at, so I figured I'd make a little series here and show you what's left of Ghostbusters Doom, and we can all sit here and, with wishful thinking, imagine what could have been a fantastic mod along the lines of Batman Doom and other media properties turned into a Doom mod type thing. So yeah, that's what we're doing here today. So let's go ahead and get started with the menu here. I have lots of phlegm in my throat. It's very, very delightful, and I'm sure you'd love to hear that. So here's the skill menu. I really like what they did with this, just because this top one, this is the very easy setting. I think if I know Ghostbusters, I think this is the old, I think there was an old, like, I think it was a Hanna-Barbera cartoon even, but there was something called Ghostbuster before the 80s movie came out, and I think that's what this is in reference to, possibly. I'm not quite sure. Now this, I don't know how many of you out there were little kids in the 90s, but yeah, I remember this show. It came out in the late 90s, and it had, like, one of the Ghostbusters in a wheelchair. It had, like, a female Ghostbuster, and she had, like, a proton pistol instead of an actual proton pack, I think. If I remember correctly. Yeah, I mean, and just like, all the Ghostbusters were old. I mean, I don't need to tell you the whole plot. It wasn't really that great. Maybe some people liked it, but I think, I don't know. It didn't compare to this cartoon, the real Ghostbusters, which I also remember from my childhood. And then Ultraviolence is basically Ghostbuster, which I'm assuming is just supposed to be a reference to the movies themselves. And then, of course, we have Nightmare Mode, People Buster. So yeah, that's our skill levels here. So let's just go with Ghostbuster. Let's be the 80s movies. So here we are. So this runs off of the old ZDoom engine. I'm running this with, I believe, 2. Let's find out here. What do we got? Oh no, that's Windows. That does not tell me. What version of ZDoom am I using? ZDoom? Can you tell me? It's not gonna tell me. Oh wait, over there on the right. Yeah, I'm dumb. It's 2.6.1. So again, this was last updated in 2002, so it's using some of the latest developments in ZDoom at the time. So one of which is the ambient noises that you're hearing here, and then what else have we got here? A nice little dehacked effect. I think he's updated this mod to run all in one package, so all you need to do is just load the WAD file that comes with it. So we got these little civilians here standing around staring at the fountain. Kind of creepily. Oh wait, this guy just turned around. So there's that. Looks like they occasionally just kind of shift positions, although she's just kind of creepily just staring at this. Just staring at the fountain, contemplating life. It's almost beautiful, really. It's almost poetic. So, okay, so in your hand here is the, if you remember from the intro scene to the first movie, is the PKE meter, which is actually your pistol. And it makes little clicking noises, and yes, it does kill people. In fact, here's what happens when you shoot it at a civilian. It unleashes a ghost. And you kill ghosts with the PKE, as you see there. Now, I had this theory that perhaps the mod maker was trying to say that all of us have just a little bit of evil inside of us. And all it takes is a PKE meter to bring it out. Hey, ow, hey. Hey, I didn't tell you that you could do that. Alright. Besides that, this is your fist. It's really more of a chainsaw. It's a taser. There we are. Well, that's a little interesting, isn't it? Slightly reflective surface, but perhaps unnecessary in this particular area. But yeah, I see we have all these little civilians just hanging around here. I'm not sure exactly how these cars got it. Oh, you can destroy the cars. Maybe I'll try to show you that. I don't think I have enough ammo to do it. Here, let's go ahead and make ourselves a save. Ghostbusters. Right. Okay, so here's... You can destroy these cars. We've already got the engine on fire. surprised I survived that. So there you go, we destroyed the car with a taser. What game allows you to do that? I mean, come on. This is not a badass game. You can destroy a car with a ghost taser. That alone should tell you to just stop watching this video and just go download this immediately. I mean, you know, clearly. Got the post office. Wait, wasn't there somebody... Wasn't... Where'd he go? Did I kill him? Maybe I did. Anyway, so here we are in the library. This is the, again, the beginning of the first movie. Go in the library. There's the librarian ghost in here somewhere, if you recall from the movie. And you'll notice the civilians are, like, making weird zombie noises. They're like, you know... That's something that probably could have been fixed. Maybe. Okay, it's just like theory craft here. You know, maybe you know, Gozer has possessed these people, and that's why they have ghosts inside of them. You know, possibly. Who knows? Anyway, let's explore the library here. Here we go. Here's our symmetrical book stacking. Because no human would stack books like this. And if we keep exploring the library, there's plenty more. Look, there's another stack of books here. Very fascinating. Yes. Seems to be ghost activity. I was trying to think of the word for that. Psychokinetic? Not quite there. You know, parapsychology, basically. Yes, there's some more books. There's a book on the ground there. You know, really making creative use of the Doom in here. Yep, more books. More and more books. There's a book right there. It's all, you know, sprawled out like that. Isn't that interesting? Alright, and then another stack of books. My god. Alright, so... That is so weird. I mean, if there's anything to be fixed, that's probably one of the little things they could fix. Now, I think we need to go this way. Ah, here we go. I think we're in the right track now. I'm gonna check our map here. Oh, wait, nope. Yeah, we gotta go this way. Here we are, going into the basement. Now check this out. So, you remember the scene in the movie where the bookshelf falls over? Has that happened to you before? First time? Now, unfortunately, you know, they don't have the library cards flying all over the place, but they do have slime all over the library cards, as you can see here, all over the filing cabinets for them, which is very, very... It's very creative, as far as Doom's concerned, I would say. Alright, and what else we got back here? It's very dark back here. Is that another book, maybe? I guess? I don't know why that's there, actually. I'm looking for ammo, but it doesn't seem like there is any, so okay, fair enough. No ammo. And then... I think we're getting close now. Oh, here we go. And there's the librarian ghost. There's some ammo for us. Alright, now, just like in the movie, let's go ahead and do this. Get her! The sound kind of fades out there, but I mean, you know, it's pretty much just directly lifted from the movie, so. That's the first level! It's just a nice, cute Doom recreation of the very beginning of the movie. So there you go. Now we adjourn to the Ghostbusters headquarters. And here we are. Now this is a really cool level. I really like what they've done with this. First of all, we gotta eat ourselves some Twinkies. They're all big Twinkies, as you can see there. Again, this is just a really cool design here, I think. Look, you hit the switch here. You got the Ghostbusters arcade game. You have this kind of mock-up of a, it's supposed to be a, you know, pinball machine, but I guess it kind of works. Got our couch here with the 80s-style, like, TV with the speaker system and everything. You never really got to see this stuff in the movie, I don't think. You know, you got the pool table, here's the bathroom. Now, you can see there's a mirrored effect, but you unfortunately can't see what you look like. By the way, if you want to see what you look like, let's see here. Player options. Here we go. See, look, there's Egon. That's what I look like. Of course, it says John on there, but whatever. But unfortunately, you can't see yourself in the reflection. But here's the shower. Here's the bathtub. That's more like a toilet, John, you know. Know your home appliances. That door seems to be locked, but that's okay. And then, of course, oh, there's the refrigerator. We can't interact with that. But then here's the good old fireman pole thing. And here we are in the garage. There's a giant oil stain on the ground there. There's some oil drums, inexplicably. I guess those are gas containers. I think that's what they were going for. And there it is, the proton pack. Now, for some fucking reason, he made it impossible to reach. How in the hell developer of this mod, why in the world would you make the iconic weapon of this movie unobtainable? What the hell is wrong with you? I can't get this at all. Like, you have to cheat to get that. We can pick up our, you know, our jumpsuit here. So there we go. We got our jumpsuit. And that's the button that opens the garage, so there's the Ecto-1 in there that we're gonna hop in just a second. There's an old-school computer. Very nice. I feel very short right now. This computer is, like, towering over me. That's okay. What do we got in here? Oh, yes, here's the containment unit with another Twinkie. Oh, here's the ghost trap. Now, let me save it real quick so I can demonstrate this. Not that it really matters, because, I mean, again, this is... Well, okay, so this is replacing the BFG. So how it works is you throw it out, and kind of like how the BFG has that flash thing where it hits anybody within your view, so when you throw this thing... Now, I wonder, I wish we could change it so it wasn't, like, transparent like that, but it's ZDoom. Well, it's the only two we get, so yeah, when you launch those things, it's like the BFG. When they explode like that, they just hit everything within your range, kind of like the BFG does. And you can't interact with the containment unit, but that's probably a good thing. Looks like it's all nice and clean at the moment. It's pretty cool how they recreated this, though, I think. Alright, and then we have all these offices over here. The Ghostbusters offices. Here's a vat full of slime, I can only assume. I don't really know. Now, here's some other weapons here. We have the ecto-resonance detector. This is basically replacing the super shotgun. You can't see because they've disabled all the bullet puffs, but... So yeah, you can detect something to death. Oh, there's a GPS unit, apparently. I guess that's the map. This replaces the gigameter, replaces the chain gun. Kind of see how that works. Then we have the Neutrona Blaster, which replaces the single barrel shotgun. Not very much ammo on that thing. Let's check out the actual Ghostbusters offices back here. This is such a depressing office. These tiny rooms that just has a pad of paper and a chair. And there's another one. At least this one has a fucking shag carpet in it. Apparently we're all full on ammo. Then we got some armor and some pistol belts. So we're all ready to rock here. We also got some other stuff back here. There we go, see? God, it just seems so depressing. And there's only three Ghostbusters at this point. I guess they haven't hired Winston yet. So, God, I mean, I would be so depressed working in such a, like, a room like this. That would suck so much. Anyway, let's get out of that depressing room. Anyway, so, and then, yeah, here. You know what? I'm just gonna have to I have to have this. I like that secret sound music. It plays like a little... So, here it is. The iconic, the proton pack? I'm such a terrible Ghostbusters fan. And it replaces the plasma rifle, and as you notice, it doesn't use any ammo, so you have unlimited ammo on the proton pack, and it works like this. So I think it's pretty badass. Not quite, like, perfect, you know, but I mean, it does what it needs to do for a Doom proton pack. I almost wish they could flip the graphic around, because you'll kind of notice there. It's not quite where it needs to be. Close enough, though, right? So here we go. We have all our weapons. Let's go ahead and hop in the Ecto-1. Now, this next level is pretty damn cool. Or at least it's pretty interesting. Now we're in the car. The streets of New York, if I could fucking talk. So check this out. This replaces the chainsaw. So look, now we're in the fucking car. We're in the Ecto-1 right now. And we have the Frank Sinatra New York, New York song playing. So here we are, driving around the Doom version of New York. Oh shit. There are ghosts all over New York. Thankfully, they have equipped the Ecto-1 with a proton pack, apparently, so... oh my god! Busted his ass. So yeah, they've just created this giant level that recreates New York in a Doom engine. We got stop signs, we got all sorts of shit. All these pumpkins running around in Central Park, apparently. That's something. What's back here? Oh, here's the harbor. And there's the Statue of Liberty over there. Harbor? I don't even know. I don't know my New York-ness, but yeah, there's your Statue of Liberty. Forgive me, New Yorkers who are possibly watching this. There's a garage. Some garage workers. What do you know? Look at that. Ah, whoa, whoa! Yeah, you can run over people. That's kind of the, that's like the, you know, chainsaw part of this thing. But look, there's a guy's ass crack. You know, it's great. So, let's keep on moving here. Yeah, there's a gas station here. You can kind of see some of the, how they pulled this off. Still very cool, though. So you got a, whoa! A pumpkin escaped. Take care of his ass. What are the gas prices? We can't even tell. Northside Convenience. Oh, hi! Running over ghosts now, apparently. Apologize for the phone. Busy. Alright, well, let's get the hell away from all these ghosts. Because there's a lot of ghosts actually running around this entire city. Now, if you remember in the movie, they get a phone call to go to the, Sedgwick Hotel? Am I pronouncing that correctly? Yes. Because, you know, that's where Slimer is and everything, right? So, I mean, I guess we can explore this a little bit further. Should, but that's where we're going, basically, so let's... Hey! Off your bullshit. Oh, man. Got giant ghosts up there. Whoa! Oh. Hey. Watch it. Hey. Yeah, it gets kind of laggy if you get really close to that explosion. Holy shit. Okay, yeah, we might not be able to survive for much longer, guys, I'm saying. Okay, yeah, all the fucking... All fucking pumpkin heads are escaping. Which is no bueno. So, oh there, okay, now we're back where we started. There's the Ghostbusters headquarters. I mean, how much of this have I explored? Looks, you know what I'm wondering? I'm wondering if this is kind of a reference. I don't know if any of you remember the...
Prehistoric events, how we do things downtown.
Do what now, Bill Murray? Oh, that's the... Like the slime monster. Let's just take him out right away. Well, we kicked his ass, but then we died. Alright, well, let's just go ahead and get the hell out of here, shall we? Alright, so this is an interesting way to exit this level. Can't go through there, apparently. Alright, let's go find that hotel.
Ow! We kicked his ass!
Damn right we did. Alright, whoa! I guess that's City Hall, or maybe a museum, or I don't even know. Red ghosts don't like to cooperate very much, do they? Alright, so here we are. Here's the, we're actually right next to the hotel now. We'll swing around here and show you what we're talking about here. Driving on the sidewalk, who gives a shit? Fucking ghosts, go away. No, fuck off. Okay, so there's the hotel, right? You're not allowed to park up front. If you try to park up front, the police officer shows up and starts shooting at you. Whoa, no, do not touch that car! You'll chainsaw the car to death. I think they just outfitted the... I think it's a cool little concept that you can run over things, technically. It's kind of, you know, it's kind of cool how they did this. But okay, so we want to go to that hotel, so this is where we park. Parking for the hotel, right here. So it's kind of a weird thing. It's one of those things where you have to sit here and wait for the health to drop all the way down to almost dead. And that's how we park the car in this game. There you go, see? Now we've parked the car. Well, you know, I'm gonna leave it here for part one. In part two, we'll be exploring the hotel and the other levels that are in Ghostbusters Doom, so... Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and whatnot, and I will see you in another video, and definitely, hopefully, in the next Ghostbusters video. So, alright. Later.